You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Fr Eustace, siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Sunday, the 1st of November, 2020, All Saints' Day, the day the church gives us an opportunity to remember and to reconnect to those who have finished their journey of faith, have fought a good fight, and that they are in heaven, enjoying the breeze of heaven. Enjoying the presence of God. And many people do wonder, why are Catholics focusing on saints all the time? Today we are going to find out the reason. Today we are going to know why for us, saints mean a lot. Saints mean a lot to us because these are ancestors of faith who help us know the path we ought to tread in order to reach where God is. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Florence Forday, a Daily Bread member from Croydon, United Kingdom.
A reading from the Book of Revelation, Chapter 7, verses 2 through 4, 9 through 14. I, John, saw another angel ascend from the rising of the sun with the seal of the living God, and he called with a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm the earth and sea, saying, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God upon their foreheads." And I heard the number of the sealed, 144,000 sealed, out of every tribe of the sons of Israel. After this I looked, and behold, a great multitude, which no man could number, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits upon the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood round the throne, and round the elders, and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne, and worshipped God, saying, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom, and thanksgiving and honor and power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, clothed in white robes, and from where they have come?" I said to him, "Sir, you know." And he said to me, "These are they who have come out of great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading will be taken by Bernadette Wanjiru, a Daily Bread member from Nairobi, Kenya.
We shall see God as He is. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. Beloved, we are God's children now. It does not appear what we shall be, but we know that when He appears, we shall be like Him. For we shall see Him as He is. And everyone who thus hopes in Him purifies himself as He is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Elijah Mutinda, a Carmelite missionary working in Barcelona, Spain.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Old Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 1 to 12a. At that time, seeing the crowds, Jesus went up on the mountain, and when he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he opened his mouth and told them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For those of you who have been following the Catholic calendar and those of you who are Catholics, you realize that every day we have a saint we remember. Every day there is somebody whom we remember. And why do we have to talk about these people? Why do we have to be edified by how these people live their lives? It's for one reason. Because we are sanctophilic. Because we like sanctity and we want to see models who have lived a life that would lead us to that, because we are all called to be holy. The letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians chapter 1 says it all. We covered the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, and in that passage we realize that God had intended from the very beginning that we should be holy and blameless before Him. But how are we going to attain that holiness if there is nobody who has attained that before? If there is nobody to show us that path towards sanctity? That is why we want to know about saints. That is why we want to know about those holy people and how they live their lives, so that looking at them, we may say, this is the way, and I will follow. And we realize that every saint was different from the other. No saint has lived the same life as the other. So we look at these different patterns of life and say, how am I also going to attain holiness? Is there a character among these saints that is similar to mine, so that I too may tread in that path? And where are we basing all this on? Basing all this on chapter 11 and chapter 12 of the letter to the Hebrews. Chapter 11 gives us the lives of the holy men and women in the Old Testament, in the Hebrew scripture. And chapter 12, verse 1 starts with these words. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us, and persevere in running the race that lies before us. And verse 2 says, while fixing our eyes on Jesus, the leader and perfecter of faith. That saints are not taking us away from Jesus. No, they are helping us to fix our eyes on him while we look for the way to get closer to him. And so we are proud to remember this special day. The church unites earth and heaven by giving us this day, All Saints Day, so that we are able to reconnect to those holy men and women, some who never even went through canonization, some who were even your family members who never were recognized by the church. The church today calls to mind all the saints, both canonized and uncanonized, probably because the process of canonization takes so long. And the church wants also to unite the earth, not just heaven, but also the earth, to heaven by saying, listen, as you live your life here on earth, you are also supposed to be saintly. You are also supposed to be holy towards the direction of God. When we celebrate All Saints Day, we are recalling the call we have towards sanctity. We want to remind ourselves that is the path we are supposed to tread as well. We see how accommodating is the heavenly sphere. Look at the first reading of today. We have categories of saints. The first category of saints is made up of the Israelites, drawn from the 12 tribes of Israel, 144,000. 12,000 from every tribe. We get 144,000, and 12 is a complete number. It is the whole tribe of Israel. It is all the believers in the community of the Israelites included there. It is not a numerical figure. No, it is a symbolic figure that says all the chosen people of God will find themselves in heaven. That is one group. The other group is made up of saints from every tribe, we are told in the first reading of today that we took from Revelation chapter 7, verse 2 to 4, and then 9 to 14. We are told, after this, I looked, and behold, a great multitude which no man could number, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were all clothed in white robes. They were all clothed in white robes from every tribe, from every nation, from every tongue. Not from some tribes. Even the Chinese were there. The Japanese were there. The Africans were there. The Europeans were there. The Americans were there. Everyone was there. How all-inclusive, how all-inclusive is the kingdom of God, where all of us have a place in heaven. All of us. No one is excluded from holiness. And when you find people trying to separate and divide people based on their tribe, based on race, these are people who don't know what the content of heaven is. These are people who don't know the essence of heaven. If you know what is found in heaven, then you will look at every man, at every woman as your brother and your sister. You will look at every human being as somebody who is also a candidate for heaven. And if we are candidates, candidates for heaven, then we are supposed to show our kindness, our love, our acceptance for people who are different from our kind. A saint is non-discriminatory. A saint is very sensitive to the way other people who are not of his kind are treated. Because he knows, because she knows, these people will find themselves with us in heaven. And so you see something different in the way people live who are aiming towards sanctity, because they know at the end of the day, all these people will find themselves with me in heaven. Then why should I show discrimination in the few years that I have here on earth when eternity awaits me to be with such people? When you know your destiny, when you know your path, when you know where you are aiming at, things will be trivial that are connected to tribe, that are connected to race, that are connected to language. You will not segregate somebody because a person does not speak your language. No, you are meant to be a saint. And meant to be a saint, you will, in fact, look at that person with sympathy who doesn't speak your language. You will look at that person with love. There is a language that everybody speaks, the language of love. And you're going to speak that language. You're going to let the world know you are not like any other. No, your aim is quite high. You are aiming at becoming like the elect, those chosen, those who are supposed to be among the uncountable. It's a number that has no numerical figure, telling us that there is room in heaven for everybody. Telling us that sanctity is the call that we all love, and we will find our grandmothers, our great-grandparents there who never even lived a Christian life, who never even knew about Christ. But because they were men and women of goodwill, they lived a life that is emulable. They lived a life that is imitable. They lived a life that somebody can admire, admirable. They are in heaven. They are among the people mentioned here, a number that no man could count. No matter how much of a mathematician you can be, when it comes to the multitude found in heaven above, you cannot count. This is an encouraging message. It is so encouraging to all of us that, listen, we all have a place in that kingdom. We just have to learn to move away from naivety of basing our relationships on race, language, tribe, tongue, nation. I don't relate to somebody because this person is from my country. No, I relate to somebody because this person is a candidate for heaven, like me. And I'm relating to those people because I also want them to be candidates for heaven. And you know what? To be a candidate for heaven, you won't get it easy. It is not something that will come on a silver platter. No, you go through trying moments. You go through very hard times. When asked about the multitude, those people who were dressed in white, those saints, who are these people? Do you know them? And he answered like the way Ezekiel answered when he was asked about the dry bones in chapter 37 of Ezekiel. Son of man, can these bones have life? Ezekiel answered, "You know, Lord. Who are these people? Do you know them?" "No, you know. You know them. You've been searching them. You've been checking on them. You've been wrestling with them. As they struggle with the trials of life, you have been attentive. You know. I And so he answers, these are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. These are people who have come out of COVID-19. These are people who have come out of marriage frustrations. These are people who have come out of job disappointments. These are people who have waited for somebody to marry them and they did not get somebody. They remained faithful to their God despite not getting the one they were looking for. These are people who, despite the problems they faced at their workplace, they did not compromise their religious faith. They did not compromise their convictions. Who, despite not getting a job they were looking for, they did not give their bodies to be used. No, they remained faithful. They remained true. These are the ones dressed in white. Wow. And I'm looking for such. And the Lord knows He's looking for such among us. He's looking for such convinced believers who are able to remain true despite anything and everything that is around them. They still maintain their faith and still want to show that they belong to God. With their eyes fixed on Jesus. They are not giving up because of the trying moments. They are not giving up because of the hard economic situation. They are not giving up because of the many disappointments they face in life. No, they remain true. They remain faithful to the end. These are the saints we are celebrating today. And these are the saints we mean to emulate today. These are the people we want to look up to and say, yes, we are hero worshippers. And which heroes are we worshipping? We are worshipping those heroes of faith. Not just the stars of music, not just men and women who have shined in this world, even in their crookedness. No, those are not our models. We are not being mentored by such. But we have the saints. We have the saints who, when we look at them, whenever we go through something, we say, yes, we are still going to stand despite anything and everything that is going on in our lives. We are still going to stand because these men and women stood. They faced trials. They were persecuted here in Rome. They remained true to the end, and we want to be like them. Why do we want to be like them? Because this is exactly the call we have in the second reading of today, taken from the letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And so we are. Because we are children of God, we want to reclaim our position as children of God. And so we are going to live exemplary lives. We're going to make sure that when I am at work, I display a face of the child of God. When I'm at work, I show my commitment at that workplace. When I am doing business, I don't show any crookedness in my business. I only make sure that I get the profit that is not exaggerated in order for me not to take advantage of others, for me to enrich myself. No, a saint doesn't live that life. We want sanctity to be visible, whether people are looking at me or they are not looking at me, whether people know what I am doing or they don't know what I am doing, because we know who knows. The one who knows is up above. That's the one John is answering when he's asked the question, do you know these people? No, you know, Lord. You look at us, you look at our hearts. We are not here to impress anybody. No. We are here because we live for God, and God whom we are going to be like. If we are going to be like God, we start practicing, we start training, we start having industrial attachment here on earth. The whole life is industrial attachment for holiness. The whole life is industrial attachment for the elect, for the chosen, for those who want to be saints. For those who are candidates for heaven, Whenever you wake up in the morning, you look at yourself and say, how am I going to have this industrial attachment for holiness today? What is expected of me in my life today to display a child of God to the world out there? That is the call we have. And so the reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. Does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. We shall be like him, and you cannot become like him if you have not been training yourself to be like Jesus. If you have not been training yourself to be as compassionate as Jesus. If you have not been training yourself to be as kind as Jesus. If you have not been training yourself to be as gentle as Jesus. To be as understanding as Jesus. To be as forgiving as Jesus. That is what we have. That is what we are expected to be. And the profile is given in the gospel passage of today of those who are candidates for heaven. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus starts preaching on that mountain by first of all giving the profile of a saint. What is this profile? He says it clearly. If you want to be a candidate for heaven, be poor in spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. To be poor in spirit here, which is characteristic of Matthew, because Luke says, blessed are the poor. Blessed are you poor. But Matthew says, blessed are the poor in spirit. He has a message to pass to us. Jesus wants to say, poverty of spirit is that total dependence on God in everything that you do. You might be rich, you might be having material wealth, but that material wealth does not prevent you from getting closer to God. That material wealth does not make you run away from the path you're supposed to tread. Being with God and consulting him at every time. Being with God and consulting him every moment of your life. That is the poverty in spirit. And that poverty in spirit is one great characteristic of a saint. I may not say anything about all the other beatitudes, but I want to tell you, if you show your poverty in spirit, you are already a candidate of heaven. A poor person is one who relies on others for his or her own needs. And a poor in spirit is one who relies on God for his or her own needs. A poor in spirit is one who does not do anything without consulting God. When a person wakes up in the morning, when a person goes for work, when a person is at work, when a person knocks off from work, she first of all consults God. That is somebody who is poor in spirit. A poor in spirit is a person who, when faced with challenges, does not just despair, but bends the knees in prayer and says, Lord, I know you know, and I know you have the answer to this. A poor in spirit is one who will never take any decision before consulting God, before bending the knees in prayer. And we want to be candidates for heaven. We are going to be poor in spirit. And we want God to guide us through this. And towards the end, he says, blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad. For your reward is great in heaven. How people want something to go wrong with us. How people just enjoy when they hear something that seems to be against the principles and foundations on which we have based our own faith. They are so happy, and it will be breaking news everywhere. Like they said about the Pope allowing homosexual marriages. when he did not. And we are so happy when such news becomes sensational and we want to spread it all over. And I want to say, we are blessed when all these things are said about us. And even calling our church evil. And even calling everything that we believe in as evil. We are blessed. Because the kingdom of God is ours and we are candidates of heaven. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you and happy Feast of All Saints, my dear saints.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I this is the air I breathe.